Hey guys, how's it going? Hope you're doing well. I'm just filming a super quick video right now about a question that I get asked a lot, which is how am I so confident? How do I recommend to other people that they become more confident? And I think that's a really good question. So I didn't want to like faff about this. I just wanted to kind of tell you guys honestly, for me, what makes me more confident. Let's just first define the word confidence. I feel like that's always a good place to start. I'm just going to Google it. Definition of confidence. Continence, not continence. Confidence. There we go. The definition of confidence: the feeling or belief that one can have faith in or rely on someone or something. So what that tells me is that confidence isn't a personality trait. It's not something that you're just born with. It's a feeling or a belief, is how the dictionary, according to Google, defines it. I think it's also really important to clarify that being confident does not equate being loud, and being loud does not equate being confident. Being shy does not equate being quiet, and being quiet does not equate being shy. Often the loudest, most bravadous people are the most insecure of all. Often the quietest people are the most confident of all. I think it's really important to note that it is a feeling. And like other feelings, it's not constant. I don't constantly feel this overwhelming confidence. It goes up and down. Sometimes I'm more confident than other times. Sometimes I wake up and I feel ambitious. Sometimes I wake up and I feel sad sometimes. That can be said for anyone. So if you're planning on defining your life by a fluctuant feeling, I highly recommend that you don't, because your life will be just as inconsistent as that feeling. I'm kind of saying something different than what I'd planned to say because I didn't realize that was the definition, but we're going to go with it anyway. On the topic of it being a faith thing, having faith in yourself, I think that sometimes, especially as a Christian, I talk about faith a lot. The verse in the Bible which says faith without works is dead. So there's saying that you believe something and then there's acting on that belief. So you don't actually have to feel like you believe in yourself. You don't actually have to believe in yourself to be confident. What you need to do is act as though you believe in yourself. For example, stand up in class and give that presentation, pretending that you actually have faith that you are going to give a good presentation, even if you don't have the faith that you are going to give that presentation. Sometimes you need to step out and act confident, act like you have faith in yourself, even when you don't. But anyway, pushing that definition aside and me telling you what gives me confidence. I haven't always been confident. I haven't always been someone who's on Instagram and YouTube. However, my parents did teach me how to be confident, how to not be ashamed of my own face, and how to not allow my feelings to get in the way of my actions. Now, what that means is, even though sometimes I feel embarrassed, I do not behave as though I am embarrassed. So my feelings do not align with my behaviors, and we really easily put that on other things. So sometimes you feel angry and you feel like you want to punch someone, but you overrule that and you don't punch them because you've been raised to know that violence is not the answer. Well, I suggest that it's kind of the same in confidence. Sometimes you feel shy and you feel like you just want to hide away and you feel like you don't want to say hi to that person, but it's important that we learn to override that feeling and to act in spite of that feeling. Another thing that I noticed was making me a lot less confident was the fear of what people think. And now this one is probably the main thing that I want to say. I think for a lot of us, the reason why we aren't confident in who we are or in what we want to do or say, or the career change we want to make, is because we are so afraid of what people are going to think. Now, what helps free me from that fear is reminding myself how little people care. It's mad once you realize it. We all spend so much time being scared of what people are going to think of us, when the truth is, not to be too harsh, not that many people are thinking about me right now. Not that many people care that I took time out of training. Not that many people care that I have a YouTube channel and sit here talking to a camera for half my day. Not many people care that I'm going back into athletics. No one cares as much as you think they do. Now, that might sound really harsh and depressing, but that is so liberating when you think about it. Do not allow the fear of the thought of what people might think about you stop you from doing what you believe you should be doing. That's absolutely ridiculous. It's absolutely insane. And what really helped me to stop being afraid of that and to be more confident is when it was sometime in uni, a friend told me that she was going to do something, then she didn't because she was scared that I might think something. I looked at her and I was like, hun, I don't care. I love you. I'm here for you, but I literally don't care. If that's what you wanted to do, go and do it. Why did you just not do this whole thing? Why the heck do you care what I think, as though as I am some like higher power with authority over your life? Absolutely not. So what I do now is that I recognize those around me who love me and who care for me, and I take into serious consideration what they think. And apart from that, we're pretty much good to go. A lot of the time, I am kind of scared of what people are gonna think, of what a guy I kind of fancy might think of a photo that I post. I'm just being honest, I do get nervous about that thing. But I simply do not allow to control my actions, otherwise we'd never get anything done. In the same way as you don't punch someone when you feel like punching them, I don't not post something when I feel scared of what people are gonna think of it. I assess all the other things, like, is this post beneficial? Is it what I believe I should be doing? And if it is, if it's not hurting anyone, then I go ahead and do it, and I don't live my life in fear, and I really believe that you shouldn't either. I'm very much aware that it is not the norm for doctors to post their life on Instagram and YouTube, and I was bricking it. I was crapping myself about what people would think. But the truth is, most people don't care. They don't care that much. Maybe they'll flippantly say, oh yeah, Sarah's that weird doctor who posts her whole life on Instagram. But that is literally like 1% of one of their days of all of their years. If that person is only investing in my life for that split second, why should I change my whole forever, change my life plan, change what I'm doing in order to get them to approve of me in that split second? They're not sat there thinking, what has Sarah posted next, and sending it to each other. And if they are, then logic would suggest that they're actually a lot sadder than me, so I'm not fussed. If people care that much, then I'm not fussed. So what I've recognized in my own life is that a lack of confidence is actually a form of selfishness and pride. It is when I value other people's opinions of me more than I value what I know I should be doing. It is when I'm not willing to allow myself to look like a fool. Like, who am I that I can't look like a fool once, twice every single day of my life? And so what I do is I uproot that pride and I say, it's okay, even if this completely flops, that's okay, because I'm human and I deserve grace and I will learn and I'll do better next time. It's okay if people don't like me. I was not made to be some worshipped specimen. I am me, and not everyone's going to approve of that. I think it's wrong to allow the fear of what other people might think of you to stop you doing what you believe you should be doing. It would be very selfish and proud of me to expect everyone to love me or to expect everyone to approve of what I do, and I don't think that's what life's about. Like, I have been surprised to find that so many of my colleagues and friends have been so nice and supportive of my Instagram and YouTube channel, and it's a great thing to feel. But I had to get past that fear and that nervousness and that lack of confidence in order to get to the place. Now, you might be hearing this and saying, yes, Sarah, I hear you, but it's hard, it's tough to do. And I agree, sometimes it's really tough to overrule those feelings and act in spite of them. And it is possible to draw your confidence, aka your feeling or faith in yourself, from other people, for example, friends and family. Now, I'm so, so grateful to God for his love and grace in surrounding me with friends and family who love me and who are there for me. And I draw so much confidence and love and self-assurance from the love of my parents, friends, and family. But you might be watching this thinking, I don't have that. Maybe you don't have close friends. I've been in a place when I didn't have close friends, and I know that it can be hard. Maybe you don't have a close family who are there for you and who support you. But can I tell you the ultimate source of my confidence? The ultimate source of my confidence is the knowledge of how much God loves me. Knowing that God loves me and cares about me and values me, puts value on me as a human being. God, who has seen all the terrible rubbish things that I have ever done, who knows me and all my flaws more than anyone ever could, more than I do, more than my mum and dad do, and yet he loves me and he takes the time to listen to my prayers and to value me and to speak to me and guide me and, like, change situations and pour out his love in my heart and give me peace and hope and supports me and opens my eyes to see things and just is there for me. The fact that God loves me, if God loves me, who the heck am I not to love me? If you get what I mean? If God has said that I am worthy of value, if God has said that I am worthy of his time, if God has said that my words are worthy of him listening to, then who am I to say anything else? And so ultimately, I draw my confidence from God's love for me. And maybe you're listening to this and you're thinking, but Sarah, I'm not a Christian. Well, number one, you can be. You totally can be. It's a non-exclusive club. Super recommend that you read the book of John in your Bible and get to know Jesus for yourself and his love, because honestly, knowing God is the best thing in my life. And I want to share that more on this channel, but I don't want to just, like, preach at you guys. Sorry. I know that maybe you're here for the fitness and the banter. But that's the truth. I love God, and knowing God's love for me gives me confidence even when everything else has failed. When I'm not able to pick myself up, when my friends can't pick me up, when my family can't pick me up, falling on the firm foundation of God's love always always refreshes me and gives me confidence to face another day. So yeah, that's it. That was supposed to be a quick video. I feel like it wasn't quick in the end. I ended up ranting, but I really hope that you've enjoyed it. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Leave me a comment letting me know what you think, and share this video with a friend who you think might enjoy it. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.